I would now like to give the floor to my colleague, Dr. Florian Koch, who will explain to you what has motivated us to carry out this event. This links back to what we've heard by the Lord Mayor. So please, I give you the floor.
Good morning on my part. Thank you very much for being here. I will use the next couple of minutes to speak about the background that made us organize this event. I'll have to repeat certain things the Lord Mayor has raised already. This is a side event to the World Climate Conference. Cities play a very important role. Why is that? And this picture shows it quite well. On the left-hand side, you see Shanghai, what it looks like today. And on the right-hand side, you see what it would look like if the Earth warmed by 3 degrees. And the blue, what you can see in blue is water. So if the Earth warmed by 3 degrees centigrade, Shanghai would be underwater. This doesn't only apply to that particular city. Other cities are affected by climate change too. Germany as well. The Hamburg Climate Report was published recently, and it clearly shows that the air temperature, precipitation, and wind will change due to climate change. If climate change measures will be successfully implemented globally, the global warming will be 1%. If not, the temperatures will increase by 5 degrees. So you have to be an expert in the city to be able to explain that this will make an impact on the German cities. The cities are affected by climate change. And this is why there are high expectations with regard to COP23. But they are not only affected, but they are also stakeholders in climate change. This becomes very clear after US President declaring that he would withdraw from the Paris Agreement, and more than 350 US citizens, amongst them the mayors of the 10 biggest US cities, got together and stated that they want to cope with the Paris Agreement. Mr. Sridharan already mentioned last Sunday's conference of local and regional leaders and the Bonn-Fitchy commitment, which was the outcome of the conference. 800,000 cities were represented, and they committed to put climate action on the political agenda and to support this action. And this is a very important step that shows that the cities are becoming increasingly active to cope with climate change, because they are affected, but also because they have to shoulder part of the responsibility. In Germany, many municipalities have been actively committed to climate action, and IFO supports these municipalities. And during the discussion, we will certainly hear more about the German cities' activities. Climate change, however, is only one of many challenges the cities are currently faced with. We are talking about smart cities, we are talking about digitization. All this will make an impact on the way in which cities operate. We are talking about social polarization requirements with regard to integration. The discussion around the refugees showed this very clearly. Affordable housing, e-mobility, what does that mean for the city's development? And all this against the backdrop that the resources of the cities are scarce, that there are financial restrictions. So the cities cannot implement everything they would like to. In our opinion, it is necessary to not tackle these problems individually, but to take into account the link between the different problems. So we have to have the integrative perspective. The Sustainable Development Goals, which were adopted in September 2015 by the United Nations in their General Assembly, show that there's this link between the different aspects, and that sustainability doesn't apply to only one goal, but that there's a linkage between the different goals. And there are many different goals: no poverty, no hunger, health and well-being, etc. So there's a whole plethora of aspects. Cities do play a very important role. The SDG number 11 has to do with cities, and it states that sustainable cities and municipalities are the goal, and different targets are mentioned, but reference is made to the other SDGs as well. In the German sustainability strategy, and its continuation based on from the year 2016, this also refers to the SDGs, and in this strategy, goal number 11 is mentioned. In Germany, What matters is the following, in particular, to reduce the amount of spaces built upon, reduce the amount of energy consumed for transport of goods and services, reducing the travel time to the agglomerations, and to avoid excessive housing expenses. So you can see that this is an integrative perspective. It's not an either or, but rather the combination of different aspects. This is not easy to achieve, and this is what we're going to speak about in our discussion. In Germany, there are different initiatives tackling the SDGs, and there's the recognition that they have to be achieved. There's an interministerial working group in the city. There are sample resolutions of the German Association of Cities on sustainability at municipal level. There's an activity by the Bertelsmann Foundation called Sustainable Municipality, and there are activities by Future Earth. So many things are going on, but as the SDGs were only adopted in 2015, we're just at the beginning. This is why the aim of this event is to create a link between the Paris Agreement, COP23, and the SDGs among German and international cities and towns. And when it comes to the practice in the field of urban development, the citizens and the academia, so how can scientists and researchers contribute? So this is also the focus of this event. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope that you will enjoy this meeting, and I pass the floor back to Ms. Kreinberg.